to say you gotta know somebody or know somebody to get somewhere these days.
Good afternoon. Get ready for Addicted to Real Estate Radio. I'm Phil Falcone with my co-host Jeremy Ricci and Larry Steinhaus here on WWDB 860 AM every Thursday from 3 to 4 o'clock. If you want to ask us a question or you have a real estate need, give us a call, 267-988-2000. You're probably wondering, who's addicted to real estate? Well, we buy houses. That's right. If you've got a house for sale, you can always give us a call. We'd love to talk to you about it, all right? We are always buying houses, and we can also help you sell one. How will we do that? Well, Addicted to Real Estate is also a real estate agency. We have three offices, one in Montgomeryville, one in Hatboro, and one in Huntington Valley. We also do investor and realtor education meetings all the time. And our next one is tonight. We're going to talk to you about that tonight, the meeting we're having tonight. It's in Northeast Philly at the Maggie's Waterfront Cafe at 7 p.m. Costs $20 to come out, and we're going to share with you some of the most brilliant ideas you've ever heard about real estate investing. Hang around on the show. We're going to talk about it right now today. So, how you guys doing today?
I'm pretty excited about tonight's meeting, actually, Phil. I'm like the energy is like, oh, I can't wait. Yeah, just a couple hours away.
New venue, you know, that's pretty cool. Yeah. It's supposed to be a nice room, nice meeting room, right on the water there.
It's an excellent location. You know, you sit in this meeting room filled with gigantic glass windows looking out onto the beautiful Delaware River.
Oh, Delaware River and beautiful. I don't think I've heard those two things in the same sentence.
And for all the people who come out and want to make sure, you know, and are afraid about our radio faces, they could look out the window while they listen.
Well, I got to tell you, most of the problems that I have in life all come from the Delaware River. I spent years on that river.
Did you drink the water from it or what? I thought it was the Schuylkill. I thought it was the Schuylkill that was people talk about in Philadelphia.
I used to spend every weekend of every summer for probably a decade water skiing out on the Delaware River right there outside of Maggie's. And you can't help but swallow some of that water from time to time. It's a powerful, dangerous place.
So is that the key to real estate investing? You have to swallow the Delaware River?
No, but I can tell you something. When you find properties that you're looking at from the river as opposed to from the street view, it's amazing how much different it looks.
That's like one of our agents, Ron, who flies a plane. He flies over properties and goes, I want that one, I want that one, I want that one, and I want that one.
It's hard to find the addresses, though, when you do
that's true.
Now, down in Sarasota, I have the Hopi Cat sitting on the beach, and we hop on that thing, and we'll go right down the coast, and there's a gated community down there you can't get into, but you can check out the houses from the water. And believe me, there's some really nice houses. Because they're on the water, obviously, there's some pretty ritzy stuff.
Well, it's tough for the guy in a plane to get the addresses, but he can throw marketing out the window. That's pretty easy.
That's it. That's how we're going to get more people to the meeting. Now, listen, if you're out, look up in the sky. You'll see banners right now flying.
Parachuting, right?
Come to Maggie's tonight.
Yep. All right, so what are we going to be talking about today, Jeremy?
Well, we have questions, as always. Can you really buy houses with none of your own money? And, well, this one we already covered, but when's your next meeting? That's an easy question.
Well, we can talk a little bit about the meeting.
Here's another one. Will Donald Trump as president help real estate? So obviously that's very topical.
I thought we had a rule, no politics on this show.
Wait, Donald Trump, who's that?
Yeah, right.
We have a hard rule that we're not going to talk about politics on this show, but we can't stop, our listeners from writing in questions that have political angles to them. So we're going to have to answer it.
And our main topic today is amazing real estate deals require none of your own money. And I think that's what makes them amazing. So we'll talk about that a lot. And, also talk about the meeting we have coming up. It's a new venue. We're all excited. You heard that. So stick around, and we will be right back.
As a real estate agent, you know that most people buy a house once every 7 years. Imagine working with clients that buy 7 houses every year. At Addicted to Real Estate, they teach you how to work with investors because they are investors. Located in Montgomeryville, Hatboro, and Huntington Valley, work at an agency built for investors, by investors, and finally learn how to invest yourself. Addicted to Real Estate Agency. Call them now, 215-321-SELL. 215-321-SELL.
I can't stand this traffic. I need a vacation. Slip away to Siesta Key in Sarasota, Florida. You can stay at one of our vacation rentals at the number one rated beach in the United States. Check out GoSiesta.com, where you can rent a fully furnished vacation rental for less than the cost of a stinking hotel room. Check out GoSiesta.com or call 863-2-SIESTA. That's 863-2-SIESTA or GoSiesta.com. GoSiesta.com or call 863-2-SIESTA.
I'm going!
When dealing with your home financing, you need a lender you can trust. A mortgage lender like Thomas Farris at First Choice Loan Services Incorporated. The purchase of your home will likely be the largest financial investment you will make in your lifetime. Work with a mortgage provider who considers your long-term financial goals and puts you first. Thomas Farris at First Choice Loan Services will provide you competitive mortgage rates and service beyond belief for every step of the loan process. Call Thomas Farris at 215-983-8649 today to visit about your mortgage needs. Thomas Farris, NMLS, number is 785398. First Choice Loan Services Incorporated, NMLS, number 210764, equal housing lender.
Robinson Insurance Group is Addicted to Real Estate's preferred insurance broker. Why deal with an insurance agent who only represents one company? Robinson Insurance Group can quote you all the companies and shop to get you the best insurance for your needs. Fix and flip, landlord coverage, last minute deals, no problem. Investor deals are no issue and nobody is ever denied. Call Robinson Insurance Group, 215-918-2555. That's 215-918-2555.
I'm Phil Falcone from Executech Suites. I got a question for you. What do you get for $495 a month at Executech Suites? You get an office big enough for one person. You get the furniture in that office. You get the telephone on the desk. You get the telephone number. You get the fax number. You get the internet. You get two full-time receptionists to answer the phone in the name of your company and patch the calls to you, whether you're in the office, in your car, or at home sleeping on a couch. You get the conference rooms. You get the mailboxes. You get the printer, the copier, the scanner. You get the janitorial service, the utilities, and free coffee. I know it's hard to believe that you could get all those things for $495 a month, but it's true. 67 Buck Road in Huntington Valley, Executech Suites. Give us a call, 215-942-7701, 215-942-7701.
Hi, I'm Larry Steinhaus, and I'm addicted to real estate. Are you a real estate investor? Do you know the value of having a real estate license? It's awesome! You get to make even more money and get exposed to deals you probably would have missed. Well, today is your lucky day. I will pay for your real estate license. Find out more by calling me at 215-378-9190. That's right, I will pay for your license. Call now, 215-378-9190. Addicted to Real Estate, bridging the gap between investors and realtors. 215-378-9190.
I dig this music, man. I wish I could play guitar, you know? All right, welcome back to Addicted to Real Estate Radio.
You can play piano. We just bought a house that came with a piano.
Yeah.
We should buy a house that comes with a guitar.
I'll tell you what, I decided not to buy that piano and learn how to play it because I just met a guy who's been playing piano his whole life. And he said, now that he's in his 60s, and he said he can't play piano like he used to. And I said, well, you mean to tell me if I learn piano now, it's going to take me 10 years to learn it, and then just as soon as I get good at it, my skills will begin to deteriorate. I said, forget it. I'm not going to do it.
You got to work on your finger muscles, I guess.
I decided instead of learning piano, I'm going to focus on real estate investing.
That's a good idea.
Mm-hmm. Hey, can you teach me something about that?
I'd be happy to. All right. From the last couple of deals you did, I think I could teach you something.
Oh, man.
All right, let's get on with the questions, all right? Jeremy is our addicted to real estate's genius, and that's why we let him hang around with us. And so we're going to ask him the first question. We're going to ask him all the questions because I just love to hear what he has to say about it. First question is, can you really buy houses with no money?
The answer to that is no. And the reason is there's two words in that sentence, buy and money, that you can't buy without money because what else could you buy with? Well, I guess you could. You could buy with some other currency. You could trade, but that wouldn't be buying. That would be trading. Mm-hmm. So you can buy houses with none of your own money.
I like that.
Yeah, sure.
That I've done a few times.
We teach that quite a bit. And you can even get paid to buy houses if you do it the right way.
I've done that a few times too.
We have several ways that we do that. seller financing could be a way you buy with none of your own money, where you have tenants make rent payments and you just turn over those rent payments to the owner, keep a little spread for yourself, and it's none of your own money as long as the place stays occupied. Take over subject to mortgages. That's another way.
That's my favorite way.
Buy a property subject to the mortgage. That's the way you can do it with none of your own money. There's a little bit of money there, but you could always take on an equity partner or come up with money other ways.
So subject to is your favorite way, Larry?
It is my favorite way.
And Jeremy, what's your favorite way?
I like owner financing if I can get 0% interest.
Yeah. Yeah, I like that too. Actually, I did one this weekend.
I need to do more of those, actually. I was talking to Phil about that, just getting more of our private money deals refinanced with seller financing.
Well, I don't necessarily feel like I have a better way. I love them all. But if I had to pick a better way, I'd pick seller financing. Mm-hmm. Because you're setting yourself up to get rich on a level that you can't do with any other kind of real estate deal. Every single payment that you make on every single one of those houses increases your net worth. So you're exponentially expanding your wealth-building capabilities. The house it's secured against is going up in value, and the loan getting paid off by your tenants is basically can be directly tracked to your own net worth.
It amazes me when you talk to people, especially new people who are getting into real estate investing, and they're like, what do I have to put down on that, 20 or 30%? I don't know how to do that. I can't come up with that money. And I'm like, I haven't put 20 or 30% down on a real estate deal in, can't remember when.
In fact, we like doing negative 10% down.
Yeah, right, exactly. Getting a couple of bucks.
Which we call wholesale to yourself, so we get paid at the closing table. Right. That warrants getting a really good deal, a really good price, or getting some phenomenal seller financing and coupling that with some private money.
Well, I can actually track the last time I used my own money to buy real estate. It was in 2009.
Well,
right? I bought, some extra money. I don't even remember where I got it from, and I bought two houses in Stover Mills. And I bought them with my own money. And since then, I've never done it. I've never used my own money again since that moment, and I have bought a heck of a lot of property since then. Maybe, I don't know if I had to guess, I mean, maybe 8 to 10 million? I don't know. I'd have to go add it up. A lot of property that I haven't bought with my own money.
Yeah, and sometimes I like to throw a little bit of money into the deal just so that I show the seller, if they're doing seller financing or the subject to, that I have some skin in the game. But it's nothing like 10 or 20, no, I'm sorry, it's nothing like 20 or 30%. Sometimes it's $5,000.
Well, I don't know why you feel that you need to have skin in the game. We should put you on the couch when we get back to the office and see if we can
rid you a little therapy session.
Yeah, rid you of that.
You really should, because I'm watching my bank account go down. You know, the $7 million is only like $6.5 million now.
Yeah. Right.
All right.
I know you can't have that much in a bank house, not FDIC insured.
That's true. Yeah.
What a joke.
All right, so the next question is pretty easy. When is your next meeting?
Tonight. Next question.
I think it's 4 hours, is that right?
Yeah, tonight. What time are we starting? 6:30, I think? 6:45? I think we have it down for 6:45.
6:45, 7 o'clock.
So 3 hours.
Come a little early. If you want to come a little early, you can do some networking with the people that are going to be there. We're expecting a nice crowd tonight, beautiful location, great food, great drinks. We got our own bartender taking care of the room so you can learn about real estate and get a buzz on. I mean, what more could you expect?
Now, you were at this meeting before, and you're a little bit more familiar with Northeast Philly. Where is it? Like where? It's Academy Road or something?
If you don't, you could just Google Maggie's Waterfront Cafe. It's right on the Delaware River, right where Linden Avenue meets the Delaware River. Very, very close to the Academy Road exit of 95. So if you want to find the place, just go to the Academy Road exit of 95. When you get off at Academy Road, you're going to turn right. You go just a long block, and you turn right again on Linden Avenue, and you keep driving until your car hits the Delaware River.
I didn't mean turn-by-turn driving directions. I just meant general vicinity.
Well, hanging around with you, I'm learning how to complicate things.
You know, what's the address? I might want to put that on my GPS.
Yeah, right.
The address would be, tell your GPS to look for Maggie's Waterfront Cafe.
Okay, I'll do that. So
that's our next meeting. What are we going to talk about?
I just want to talk about last night. You were like the guest of honor at a meeting last night. That was pretty awesome.
Yeah, we did.
I can't tell you who it was. Because
creative acquisition techniques.
Yeah, that was pretty neat.
And we call it Jeremy, Screwy Deals.
Jeremy is always a brilliant speaker. So last night, if you were there, you really enjoyed that meeting. And then tonight will be even better because Jeremy and Phil will be there. And I'll be there, too. I might even pop my head up and say, hi, guys.
I think we might let you talk for a few minutes.
All right, good, because I like talking.
Yeah.
The only reason I was brilliant is because they had a lot of spotlights shining on the front stage, but that's it.
Yeah, tonight's meeting is going to be really important. I mean, if you want to learn, I've been in this business since 1989. I have done nothing but real estate investing for 27 years. It's pretty safe to say that I've learned a few things about this business. And really, what I've learned can be explained to you in a two-hour meeting, and that's what I'm going to do tonight. I'm going to share with you the strategies, the ideas, and the concepts that I took 27 years to develop, and in 2 hours, you're going to know how to do it. It's that easy. So get your butt to this meeting.
So if somebody says, I want to learn everything you know, Phil, you said, okay, fine, give me 2 hours.
I'm not going to teach him everything I know, but I'm going to teach him the strategies for which I believe is all you need to know to become very wealthy and to become a professional real estate investor and to quit your job and all the wonderful things that comes with the freedom that I'm going to teach you about tonight. Maggie's Waterfront Cafe. Get there by 7.
And if you haven't heard this before, I met these guys a few years ago and went to one of the meetings, and that's how I learned my favorite way of acquiring properties, which is subject to. I watched Jeremy teach it, and I said, wow, that's amazing. I can't believe people will do that. And I actually, not only did I master it, but 3 weeks later I did my first subject to deal, and I've been doing quite a few. Matter of fact, I have 3 on the table right now, subject to deals from this weekend.
Yeah.
And it's all about because I went to this meeting and spent $20.
How hard is it to do a subject to deal? It's pretty easy, right? You go in front of a notary, you bring the seller, you say, sign here, press hard, notarize this, record the deed, done.
Absolutely.
Obviously, you have to make sure that you're willing to take over their mortgage. The terms are good.
I got a bone to pick with Larry here now. You're telling this story over and over and over again, how you came to a meeting and you learned how to do a real estate deal from watching Jeremy, okay?
Right.
Okay, I'm well aware of all the speaking gigs that Jeremy's done over the last 5 years because I've been standing in the room doing it with him. Was I invisible that night? I must have been pretty unimpressive.
Phil had the assist. I had the goal.
Well, if you ever listen to Phil, and you guys all listen to the radio show, you know Phil just goes on and on and on and on and says nothing. And that's Jeremy, who has all the details. Unfortunately,
I still go on and on and on, too.
We need Phil and Larry to interpret Jeremy.
Well.
What do you think, Macaroni? What do you think? Do you agree with me that he just goes on and on and on and on and on? He doesn't even want to answer.
No. I mean, you're supposed to go on and on. It's a radio show, you know?
Well, yeah. But that's beside the point. You ever listen? Has he said anything of substance today?
Yeah, I always learn from him.
No, what did he say today that it was of substance? What have you learned so far in the last, almost half an hour? What have you learned so far?
I think he was on
that you can buy money without using your own money.
You buy houses without...
Yes.
Right. But anything else?
A lot. I'm listening to you guys.
So you haven't even learned that in the last half an hour, that in 3 hours we have a meeting that's going to be an incredible meeting. You haven't even heard that?
No, not yet.
You see, Phil? Nobody listens to you.
I listen to Phil.
You should come to our meeting.
Really I should.
Yeah.
You learn a lot from the meeting.
See,
I learn a lot from this.
Change your shirt, though.
I love this shirt.
He was paying attention. I thought he was trying to get a girlfriend on his cell phone or something.
Macaroni.
There's a lot of girls with money at those meetings, man.
Macaroni, you now coming you got, out to the meeting tonight?
I would tonight, but I'm here all day.
Okay, so you don't work here until 7 o'clock at night, do you?
Yeah, I actually do. I work till 8.
Okay.
What else are you doing on Thursday?
We'll still be there.
Night?
We'll still be there at 8.
We're going to be there until midnight.
There until midnight?
Probably 11:30, I would imagine, yeah.
Look, you show up, man. We're going to pull you on stage and let everybody know you're our producer.
That'd be a compliment. I would love that.
Absolutely. We'll see. Listen, I want everybody to call in the show right now and tell Macaroni to show up tonight. They can call Phil's number. What's your number?
No, we can have him call your number on this one.
All right, so on to the next question. I'm asking this of you, Phil. Will Donald Trump as president help real estate? You're the pound your chest on Donald Trump guy. I don't know. I don't know about. I know he's in the real estate business, so I don't think he's gonna have Congress push any laws to inhibit people doing real estate deals for sure.
I would agree with that. Yeah. I don't want to have a political discussion about Donald Trump. I merely want to answer the guy's question. Right? I think it would be virtually impossible to imagine a world where a man who claims that his net worth is $9 billion and it's all real estate, that he would do anything to affect that.
No, yes. part of the $9 million is his brand that billion. He values. Or billion. Billion. You're right, yeah. Million would be chump change.
For sure.
But he says my brand is worth X or it's worth Y, and he changes that figure all the time.
The real question is, do you think that if he becomes president, he'll put a giant sign that says Trump's White House?
What if the building?
The Trump House.
You know what would be funny is if he put a for sale sign in the front of that lawn. He said, we don't need it. I already got a nice place. Let's put this thing up for sale.
Well, didn't the Clintons already do that when they rented Barbara Streisand the bedroom that Lincoln slept in for $50,000 a night?
Well, who got that money?
Who do you think got it? Certainly, certainly didn't go to pay off the deficit, if that's what you're asking.
There's a deficit. How we're going to – the plan to pay it back is to rent out the White House bedrooms.
Well, I just remember that they did that. Like Barbara Streisand apparently wanted to spend a night at the White House, and there is a bedroom. And you know, part of the White House is the original White House. Most of the White House has been, you know, an addition. So the White House is a huge building now. But
they get permits for that? Zoning?
Yeah, right.
Good question, yeah. I think they did, but they didn't pass inspections. You know?
Yeah.
And supposedly, the story goes that when Clintons were president, well, Barbara Streisand was a donor to their campaign. It's fascinating that somebody from Hollywood and California would be supporting the Democrats. That's a big surprise there.
Yeah, right.
I'm just shocked that we went from a question that was, you know, will Donald Trump as president help real estate
to Barbara Streisand.
Barbara Streisand and the Clintons.
Well, would you rent a bedroom out of your house for $50,000 a night? I think I'd take that deal.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. It's good money. Nice profit margins there.
Yeah.
Okay, so what is your opinions on Donald Trump?
So I think you're absolutely right, but I also think that it won't matter. I believe that, you know, what I see in the cycles, and I mentioned this before, I like to look at charts. And
church?
I see, at charts, and the charts tell me that there's absolutely no possible way that real estate will go down in the next 5 years. In fact, it's going to be incredible the next five
He's
years.
He's like a fortune teller. He looks at these charts. You know, it's like a crystal ball.
Yep, absolutely.
Flip it over tarot cards.
Yeah, I do it in the stock market, and I do it in real estate. And real estate charts are screaming buys right now.
You know what?
Screaming buys.
You know what, Law? I'm hoping that gets passed when he's in office. I'm going for Section 8.1. You've heard of Section 8, right? Well, Section 8.1 is government-assisted vacations. So we can get vacation rentals and get checks from HUD for our vacation rentals. What do you think? Section 8.1.
You can answer that.
Does it have a little indicator that says Section 10? Oh, wait, I'm sorry. That was Windows.
Yeah.
All right, it was a bad joke. I tried. I tried to put it together, but it didn't work.
I thought 8.1 was pretty funny. Trying to get
hey, Macaroni, cut out Larry's bad joke,
yeah.
Will you? All right.
Bleep that.
So we come to the end
of
the
He didn't hear
show.
You anyway.
I know, he's not listening. He's probably on a porn site or something.
Jeez.
All right. So we're at the end of this segment. Stick around as we discuss amazing real estate deals require none of your own money. We're going to tell you a little bit about what we're going to be talking about at tonight's meeting, so make sure you listen in. And you are listening to Addicted Real Estate Radio. We'll be right back.
Have you heard about the recent low mortgage rates? Have you started thinking about refinancing your home? Why not work with a mortgage lender who puts you first? Thomas Farris at First Choice Loan Services Incorporated will provide you personalized service to make sure your home financing meets your needs both now and in the future. Call Thomas Farris at 215-983-8649 today and learn how the current low interest rates may mean it's the right time for you to buy or refinance. Call Thomas Farris at 215-983-8649. Thomas Farris, NMLS, number is 785398. First Choice Loan Services Incorporated, NMLS, number 210764, Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, my name's Phil Falcone. I wrote a book called Addicted to Real Estate, Why I Can't Stop and Why You Should Start. And if you'd love to see an investment book written by a Philadelphian about investing in Philadelphia, I'm your man. You can check out my book at addicted2realestate.com with the number 2. I have a free web TV show there. I have free investment forums for real estate investors.
and I have my book that you can check out, Addicted to Real Estate, Why I Can't Stop and Why You Should Start, and the website is addicted2realestate2.com.
Robinson Insurance Group is Addicted to Real Estate's preferred insurance broker. Why deal with an insurance agent who only represents one company? Robinson Insurance Group can quote you all the companies and shop to get you the best insurance for your needs. Fix and flip? Landlord coverage? Last minute deals? No problem. Investor deals are no issue and nobody is ever denied. Call Robinson Insurance Group, 215-918-2555. That's 215-918-2555.
As a real estate agent, you know that most people buy a house once every 7 years. Imagine working with clients that buy 7 houses every year. At Addicted to Real Estate, they teach you how to work with investors because they are investors. Located in Montgomeryville, Hatboro, and Huntington Valley, work at an agency built for investors, by investors, and finally learn how to invest yourself. Addicted to Real Estate Agency. Call them now, 215-321-SELL. 215-321-SELL.
I'm Phil Falcone from Executech Suites. Do you have a voicemail machine answering your business calls during the day? Oh, please tell me it's not true. I have an answering service for you that only costs $99 a month, where real humans, that's right, we have live humans answering the phone in the name of your company and patching the calls to you for only $99 a month. And there are no contracts, so you can try it out anytime you like and cancel it whenever you like. Executech Suites, 215-942-7701.
Hi, I'm Larry Steinhaus, and I'm addicted to real estate. Have you been thinking about getting your real estate license? Well, have I got news for you. We are currently training new agents to be addicted to real estate. If you are tired of your day-to-day, paycheck-to-paycheck life, I will pay for your real estate school and your license. Become addicted to real estate on me. Hurry before we change our minds. Call me at 215-378-9190. That's 215-378-9190. Call now, 215-378-9190.
Addicted to Real Estate Radio. This is Larry, and I'm here with my guys, my buddies, Jeremy and Phil, have taught me everything I know about real estate. Almost everything I know. But Jeremy definitely taught me about subject too. So we're talking about tonight's meeting again.
Did you just say that to upset me?
Of course I said it to upset you, Phil. That's what this show's all about, how I can upset Phil today.
Okay. Let's go there. Let's do it.
He's so upset he's not even going to answer me.
You don't want to pick on Macaroni? I thought that was the plan.
No, Macaroni's easy to pick on.
Yeah.
Just his name is easy to pick on.
Jeez.
All right, what's the main topic today?
The main topic is let's discuss upcoming meetings and why you should attend. Would that be the main topic? Because
no.
I've totally
amazing,
lost.
Amazing totally real estate lost, deals require none of your money.
Oh, yeah, that's a much better topic. I've totally lost my place.
So we're going to talk about the different ways that we buy deals with none of our own money. And the reason we're going to talk about that is because a lot of people that want to get in this business have this misconception that you need a bunch of money to get started.
Or credit
to get started.
And you don't need either.
You know, so I think that if you ask real estate agents even, how come you don't invest in property yourself? What do they say? Larry, what do you hear that real estate agents say?
I have no money.
Time.
I'm afraid of it.
Phil had a girl that said, I can't do that. I got two kids.
Right.
Yeah, that was her reason. Before I had my real estate license, I had a local agent was helping me out. And she became intimately familiar with the strategies I was using, which, incidentally, I'll be teaching tonight at Maggie's Waterfront Cafe. And one day I just said, can I ask you a question? I mean, you obviously have a pretty good handle on this stuff. You understand it. You see me doing it time and time and time and time again. You've complimented me on it. Why don't you do it? She said, well, you know, I got two kids. And I'm, yeah, you got two kids. Well, I'm pretty sure that real estate investors procreate. Pretty sure that they're involved in that action in the evening when they're not investing in real estate. It's just funny.
Real estate investors make kids too. That's
what I would say that is it's a self-created mental limitation.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Self-limiting belief, they call it, right? Like, I need money to do it.
Yeah, and unfortunately, it's funny because most people going down the path, you remember the game of life? There were two paths. There was the poorhouse and the millionaire mansion.
I thought it was like college and not college.
Well, that was one path, but at the end, you either went to the millionaire mansion or you went to the poorhouse. and most people are on the track to the poorhouse. And the funny part is, if they took the risk and lost, you know, they did a bad deal, did a whole bunch of bad deals, they're going to the same place anyway. So they might as well take the risk and move and possibly have the potential of going to the millionaire mansion. And I see this over and over again. I have this conversation with people who have no money or they're just stuck in this fear that, well, what if it goes bad? Well, so what? Your life is already going bad. Why not fix it?
I went out to dinner the other day with a guy who started in the real estate investing business when he was in his 50s. And that's when he started. And he's building wealth in a rapid fashion starting in his 50s. He did it, you know, supplementary to his other day job. And he loves his day job, but he also wants to build wealth. So even if you love your day job, you can do this on the side. You can do it part-time. You don't need to stockpile a bunch of money to get started.
You can go from zero to $1 million net worth in less than a year by aggressively buying real estate the way we buy it. There's no doubt. It's absolutely true.
You need a little bit of money. You need $20 to come to our meeting tonight.
That's right.
You need maybe some money to crank out some marketing, but not even really. You can go door knocking and knock on some doors.
That's right.
If you don't have the $20 to come to our meeting, do we offer a seller financing option?
Seller financing, yeah, $2 an hour for the next 10
hours.
$1
a year for the next 20 years.
I like $2 an hour for the next 10 hours.
Mac, we might have to get Macaroni to pay $1 a year for the next 20 years.
You know what's funny is a lot of the real estate agents and don't really understand the none of your own money thing, and even mortgage guys, because that's the world that they're used to.
Sure.
And I was explaining to one of the agents in our office, even the agreement of sale in Pennsylvania doesn't even have a section for owner financing. Doesn't even have a place for that. And then they have this myriad of addendums and other forms that they have in their repertoire of forms, and there isn't even any kind of addendum in there. You know, where's the seller financing add-on to the agreement of sale? And you got to look it up by all these crazy acronym letters for all, you know, I can never find the forms I'm looking for. But it's not in there.
So. Yeah, when we have real estate agents come to our office, you know, who came from the big box real estate stores and came to us because they want to learn real estate investing, I have to unlearn them or unteach them. I'm not sure what the proper word is, because they're so used to these deals that, you know, you go there, this is how it's done, and this is the only thing they've known for the last 10 years. And I teach them, well, there's things like subject to and owner financing. And like, what do you mean? I don't get it. How does it work? How does the title come? What do you do? And I have to teach them.
And the way that we did a workaround on that is we came up with our own forms. We came up with our own contracts. We have a whole kit of contracts. We call it the buyer's briefcase. And they're investor-friendly agreements, so investor-friendly forms, forms that give you the right disclaimers to make sure you cover your assets, right?
Right, absolutely, yes. Yeah, and you know, and again, my favorite subject to deals, I use Jeremy's and Phil's forms from the buyer briefcase, and they are phenomenal. I love them.
Larry came in to me the other day and said, what form do I need for this? And he's like, can you print that out? Can you send that to me? I'm like, wait a second, did you buy the buyer's briefcase?
Okay, well, let's put them on the payment plan.
It's well worth it.
Yeah. But, you know, part of that is there's another fear there is that people getting into the business, they have a big fear of, am I going to get the paperwork right?
Right, absolutely. And it's one of the things that, you know, that we do and, you know, that we've been doing for a while is, you know, people call us. They call us all the time. They call us from the show. They call us from other places. And they say, hey, you know, I'm working on a deal that's like this. What do I need to do it? You know, and we talk to them about it, and we help them, and we do that constantly. You know, we have people who come into our office, become real estate agents, and they come to meetings. We teach at least once a week. We teach real estate agents how to be better real estate agents and also how to be better home investors.
We had a closing where we're selling a property that we had as a rental for years, and the title company. It's not the title company that we typically use because the buyer picks the title company. You know, they're the ones paying for it. So they generally pick the title company, even though we tried to, you know, have them use an investor-friendly title company.
Right, exactly.
And I had a conversation. We owned the property in trust and had the conversation with the title clerk about the owning the property in trust, and she wanted to see the documents and all that. And, you know, it's fine. And she was very intrigued, very interested about this trust thing. So I should invite her to the meeting. It's, you know, there's a lot of people that don't understand. They just understand the vanilla deals. They don't understand the more creative, you know, I wouldn't say creative, but maybe outside the box deals.
Oh, I've gotten some fun responses from other real estate agents. When I submit a deal that's on the MLS, and I submit, you know, one of my own deals, and I put it in trust, I've gotten anything from, "What's a trust? Is this legal? I have to talk to the buyer has to talk to their attorney first." The seller has to talk to their attorney first. I'm like, "What are you talking about? This is so simple."
I like it when I go into a bank and open up a trust account.
Oh, yeah,
they say like, "Hey, we got a guy here opening up a trust fund."
Right.
And they're like, "Whoa, stop everything. This is right. A big shot."
I have 28 trust accounts in just one bank, yeah. And I deal with several banks, and it's hysterical when I walk in. They're like, they actually love me when I walk in because they can't wait for me to open another account.
More paperwork, right?
Yeah, exactly.
They get spiffed for the paperwork.
Right. So it's very different, but it's a different world. But, you know, you guys, you know, if you listen to this show and you think this is complicated, it's not. It's so easy. It's just a matter of just getting up and doing it. Come tonight. Talk to us. And look, you know, I mentioned it before. You know, we teach our real estate agents all of this. We teach us marketing. Call me. I've mentioned it. You probably heard the commercial. I will pay for your real estate license. Call me directly, 215-378-9190, and I will pay for your license, and you will learn these things.
We had our old account that we used to use sent a question to me on Facebook that he had also asked answer on the show, and he said that he's got clients constantly asking him that they're looking for deals in Philadelphia, Montgomery, Bucks, Chester County, and they can't find any deals.
Oh, that's funny.
I mean, that's a pretty broad area.
Yeah, really.
Can't find a single deal? Come on.
Yeah. My phone rings 3 to 4 times a week with deals, with people with deals. I can't buy them all. It's, you know, you guys, if you're not out there looking for deals, you won't find them. They're not going to come to you. People aren't going to knock on your door and say, "Hey, will you buy my house?" Oh, well, they will call your truck.
Yeah. it's a function of marketing, and it's a function of telling people what you do. I mean, I remember selling the very first house I wholesaled. Well, I bought it and then turned around and sold it 15 minutes later. But I found the person that bought the house for me in my dentist office. It was the dental hygienist's husband. And it was just, you know, even when they have sharp instruments in your mouth, I was telling them about what I did.
I don't know.
Hey, I got this house, and I want to talk to you about it because it's a really, really good house. And
suction.
By the way, there's an assistant having the money to lend on this house.
Yeah, I can see you doing
Phil's
that.
Impersonations are awesome.
Yes, definitely.
I could see you doing that.
Yeah, tell people what you do. If you love what you do, you just talk about it all the time.
You know, one of the things I think that makes Jeremy a great real estate investor is just his energy when he gets excited about something. So I like to tell people the story of this this house. It was on Schoolhouse Road. What's that little development there in Chalfont?
In the Highlands?
Yeah, Highlands, right? What was the name of the street that house was on? Can't even remember. You think
Krista
Court, right? Yeah. So one day we're in the office. Jeremy asked me to meet him at the office to go over something. He says, "Hey, I got to go get a cup of coffee. You know, you want something?" I said, "Nah, I'm good." And he leaves, and he's gone for like 3 hours.
And that's typical of Jeremy, by the way.
I know.
So we didn't even think anything of it.
Okay, and I'm pretty upset because I wasn't even going to be at the office. He asked me to come there to talk to him, right? When he comes back, I mean, I'm contemplating physical violence on Jeremy at this point. And he comes back and he says, I met this lady in Lyon and she's got a house for sale and blah, blah, blah. And he went to the house. He looked at the house. He pulls out some contracts out of the buyer's briefcase and he bought the house subject to the existing mortgage. So he asked me if I could go right to work on finding somebody to renovate the house. I went to look at it, and they were moving out like in a couple of days.
Yeah.
And I had to go find somebody to renovate it and change the carpets and blah, blah, blah. So over the course of maybe like 3 weeks, I had gotten a guy in there to do some painting and change the carpets and was working on all this. And then I wanted to sit down and have a meeting with Jeremy, just discuss like what we're going to sell the house for. And he goes, I already sold it last night. Some guy on my hockey team.
It was in the locker room. Yeah,
it was in the locker room of his hockey team. And we sold the house, and we made, like, a lot of money off of it. It was, like, $70,000 or something. And I'm like, this is great. Like, you know, I mean, go out and get some coffee, will you?
I was going to say, but did he ever bring you the coffee that day after that?
I never wanted a coffee. He was getting one.
Oh, he was going for right? Okay.
You know, what's funny is I went to my daughter has this daddy-daughter dance at her elementary school. And this is the first time that I've been to one of these. And The only gripe that I had is my daughter wouldn't allow me to wear my Addicted to Real Estate name tag to the daddy-daughter dance. Because I figured there's going to be a lot of people there. You know, the way these dances work is you bring your kid, you walk in the front doors, your kid runs away and plays with your friends, and then the dads all sit against the wall like wallflowers while the kids all dance. I figured I would get a lot of conversation out. She wouldn't let me wear my name tag.
I want you to know that Jeremy's wearing his name tag during the show right now.
The radio show.
Yeah. Absolutely. And all of you who can see it can see that it says, hello, my name is Jeremy Ricci, and I'm addicted to real estate.
That's right.
Great marketing. I wonder where that came from.
That's a very some really smart guy wrote a book called that.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you, know, the fact that we can use that is just amazing to me.
The name tag. I think the name tag came from. Do you remember where the guy, what country the guy was from that designed?
I don't
the name
remember
tag?
What country it was from, but I went onto this website and
it's
held
like a design
held
contest. Yeah.
What was the name of that website? Was it?
Yeah, I don't know. They didn't pay for advertisements, so we don't have to plug them.
It was a contest. I offered $200 for the person who came up with the best logo for the phrase "addicted to real estate." We got some really cool designs. One of them was looked like a hypodermic needle.
Yeah, it was like Liberty One in Philadelphia. It was a hypodermic needle.
It wasn't Liberty One. It was the Chrysler Building in New York. Instead of a needle, it was a Chrysler Building being injected into the veins.
Yeah, that's pleasant.
Yeah, right. Exactly. Right.
And one guy developed a prescription bottle spilled over with little greenhouses and red hotels falling out of it. But the one that we went with was the concept of the name tag. All you could see in the picture was a guy's chest with a tie, and he had a name tag that said, hi, my name is whatever, and I'm addicted to real estate. And I said, boom, that's it. Right? So that's the one I picked. Because
I'd like to see that artwork. I know we had the name tag out of it, but I don't remember seeing the one with the tie.
I still have it, right?
Yeah, it'd be cool.
And the whole point behind it was, imagine that you're at an Alcoholics Anonymous meeting. What's the first thing they're going to make you say? You're going to stand up and you're going to go, hi, my name's Larry, and I'm an alcoholic. Right.
Hi, Larry.
Hi, Larry.
I don't say I'm an alcoholic, though.
I know, but I'm just,
I say I'm addicted to real estate, Phil.
I prefer to use your name.
I don't want anybody to think I'm an alcoholic.
No, I'm not suggesting you're an alcoholic.
Hey, Macaroni, you got any vodka? And they said no.
Right, so, that's where we got it, and it's funny how things happen in life, you know? And I remember the other artists were really upset because they were like, what are you talking about? What's that got to do? What's the name tag got to do with it? Being addicted. They were really, I was getting like nasty emails.
Yeah, it was perfect. It's perfect.
It's absolutely perfect. Yeah. And the second I saw it, I knew it's what I was looking for.
Well, when you're at the gas station getting some coffee,
right?
You know, people see the name tag and they actually ask about it. So it's almost like a reverse icebreaker.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so they ask you, hey, what did you have, a seminar with this name tag? No, it's because I'm addicted to real estate. Let me tell you about what I do, blah, blah, blah. And get right into it. And I get people say, oh, you know what? My mom's looking to sell her house. She went to a nursing home, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah,
so you get a lot of good conversation. It's a conversation starter.
I love it. It's a great name. Thanks, Phil. I appreciate you coming up with that name.
Thank you. You're welcome. All right, guys, stick around as we discuss the three pillars of buying houses with none of your own money. You're not going to want to miss it, so get your butt back here. You're listening to Addicted to Real Estate Radio. We'll be right back.
As a real estate agent, you know that most people buy a house once every 7 years. Imagine working with clients that buy 7 houses every year. At Addicted to Real Estate, they teach you how to work with investors because they are investors. Located in Montgomeryville, Hatboro, and Huntington Valley, work at an agency built for investors, by investors, and finally learn how to invest yourself. Addicted to Real Estate Agency. Call them now, 215-321-SELL. 215-321-SELL.
Hi, my name's Phil Falcone. I wrote a book called Addicted to Real Estate, Why I Can't Stop and Why You Should Start. And if you'd love to see an investment book written by a Philadelphian about investing in Philadelphia, I'm your man. You can check out my book at addicted2realestate.com with the number 2. I have a free web TV show there. I have free investment forums for real estate investors. And I have my book that you can check out, Addicted to Real Estate, Why I Can't Stop and Why You Should Start. And the website is addicted2realestate2.com.
Robinson Insurance Group is Addicted to Real Estate's preferred insurance broker. Why deal with an insurance agent who only represents one company? Robinson Insurance Group can quote you all the companies and shop to get you the best insurance for your needs. Fix and flip, landlord coverage, last minute deals, no problem. Investor deals are no issue and nobody is ever denied. Call Robinson Insurance Group, 215-918-2555.
That's 215-918-2555.
Hi, I'm Larry Steinhaus, and I'm addicted to real estate. Are you a real estate investor? Do you know the value of having a real estate license? It's awesome. You get to make even more money and get exposed to deals you probably would have missed. Well, today is your lucky day. I will pay for your real estate license. Find out more by calling me at 215-378-9190. That's right. I will pay for your license. Call now, 215-378-9190. Addicted to Real Estate, bridging the gap between investors and realtors. 215-378-9190. I can't stand this traffic. I need a vacation.
Slip away to Siesta Key in Sarasota, Florida. You can stay at one of our vacation rentals at the number one rated beach in the United States. Check out GoSiesta.com, where you can rent a fully furnished vacation rental for less than the cost of a stinking hotel room. Check out GoSiesta.com or call 863-2-SIESTA. That's 863-2-SIESTA or GoSiesta.com. GoSiesta.com or call 863-2-SIESTA.
I'm going!
Welcome back to Addicted to Real Estate Radio. And on this segment, we're going to talk about the three pillars of buying houses with none of your own money. We mentioned them a little bit before, but Phil, what are the three pillars?
Pillar number one, private money.
I had a guy come up at the meeting with a shirt on that said, we lend money or something like that. I said, I'm a private lender. He said, well, you have a shirt on. It's not so private.
Yeah, and people think that you can't find private money. I'm amazed that.
Well, let's first talk about what it is.
Oh, sure.
We'll explain what it is. Right. I mean, just like a bank lends money to you to buy a real estate deal, private individuals may have money that they are investing in the stock market or wherever they are, and they might be perfectly willing and very happy to lend it on a piece of real estate if they knew that that was even an option. And a lot of people don't know that it's an option. And all you do is you go around, you talk to individuals, and you let them know that, hey, I'd be willing to pay you X amount of dollars. You know, I'd be able to pay you an interest rate, and I'm going to give you a note and a mortgage secured against a piece of real estate just like you got when you borrowed from money from a bank whenever you did it. The only difference is that banks are very rigid, and they have all kinds of rules and regulations about the way that that money can be lent. For example, they're going to want 20% down. They're going to lend 80% of the sales price of the house, where a private individual, you have a lot more flexibility. So let's just say that your private lender is Uncle Harry. I would go up to Uncle Harry and I'd say, hey, Uncle Harry, how's your money doing in a stock market? He said, well, it's not doing too well. You know, the world's on fire over in Europe with all these problems, and I'm a little concerned about it. And I said, well, you know, what kind of money are you making in the stock market last year? He says, well, you know, I only made 5%. I said, well, tell you what, I'd be happy to pay you 7% on this piece of real estate that I just bought. I got it under contract. I'm settling on it in 3 weeks. And I'd be happy to pay a 7% interest-only loan on this particular house. And maybe I bought the house for $100, but the house is worth $150. Now, the bank would only lend me 80% of the 100, so they'd only lend me 80 grand. But my Uncle Harry is a lot easier to talk to. And I would explain to my Uncle Harry, hey, look, this deal's worth 150 grand any way you slice it. I did a great job finding this deal. Uncle Harry, would you lend me $120,000 on this $150,000 house? And he probably would. Now I can buy the house entirely, have $10,000 to cover some closing costs and some repairs that are needed, and put $10,000 in my pocket. Hence, I just got paid to buy a piece of real estate.
Now, there's one caveat to that whole thing. Uncle Harry has to know you, like you, and trust you.
Right, absolutely.
So
right.
If your relatives aren't willing to lend you money, and we have tenants that come to us and say, my parents won't co-sign. Well, if your parents don't trust you.
Yeah. And here's another thing, too, Phil, that's kind of neat about that deal, that you just got paid to buy real estate. If you have a real estate license, I've done similar deals, three last month actually, where I actually got the real estate commission on top of getting paid to buy the real estate, which was kind of neat too. So I made an extra $7,500 last month just on buying deals off the MLS that people lent me money.
Awesome. I would encourage you not to do that. I would encourage you to discount the price of the property by your real estate commission instead of taking it as earned income.
I agree, but they won't do that because I'm buying it from banks.
Okay.
So if they're REOs, the commission's there. They have to give it to you.
Sure.
So I take it. I'm not going to say I'm not going to take it.
Right. Of course not. And it just goes to show you, Larry, that having a real estate license and being an investor is a perfect combination.
Absolutely.
And, you know, all you need to do now is go to school and pay for it. Whoops. You don't have to pay for it because we pay for your schooling for you. Let's talk about another beautiful thing about the private money example that I gave you. Not only did I buy a house with none of my own money, and I got paid $10,000 to buy the house, which is a beautiful thing. And guess how many tax dollars I have to pay on that $10,000? Nothing.
It's proceeds of a loan. So yeah.
Right. It's a loan. It's actually a loan.
Who are you going to get to repay it?
I'm going to get the tenants to repay it because the tenants are going to rent the property, and they're going to pay me every month, and I'm going to pay Uncle Harry out of that. But here is my favorite part of the private money deal, one of the pillars. My favorite part about it totally is that I just helped my uncle. My uncle was uncomfortable with the stock market. He was only making 5%. He wasn't doing well. He had a lot of future concerns about the stock market. And I came along and gave him the safest possible investment he could ever have, a piece of real estate, something that he understands. You know why he understands real estate, even though he's not an investor? Because he's lived in a house his whole life. Okay, he's always been in a house. He's always lived in some house. He understands the concept of a piece of real estate. Being able to live in it is something worth a tremendous amount of money. Having the ability to rent it and all the other things that you can do with real estate. So I helped a family member, and he's thrilled about it. Okay, and now he's telling his friends, and that's the next thing I do. I wait a few months until he's been getting paid every month, and then I call up Uncle Harry, and I go, how are you? Are you comfortable with the deal we just did? Hey, do you know anybody else who might like to make 7% on their money? And voila, you got yourself the money raised for your next couple of deals.
I got to do that. I got to ask our existing private lenders for some referrals first, because we got a lot of deals in the pipeline now. And it wouldn't be bad to do.
I know one guy who's really, really good about that. He's very diligent about calling up anyone he does business with, asking them if they're happy, and then when they say they're happy, he then asks them for names of three other people that he can make happy as well. And if they're not lying to you, if they're truly happy, it should be a piece of cake. You know, we need to do more of that.
That makes a lot of sense, yeah. I forget to do that. I should.
Yeah, it's good advice, and anybody you do business with, you should always thank them anyway.
Well, to put that on the scope of things that your new assistant's going to need to do is remind you to call up the people who are happy and borrow money off of them.
Yeah, I'm hiring an assistant. I need somebody that's uber organized that can whip me into shape to make sure that I stay on. You know, I need to be in front of the sellers, and I need somebody else to help me with the paperwork. So,
and if you'd like to apply for that job, it's 215.
No phone numbers. Okay. We would like. If you'd like to talk about the apprentice position that is available
assistant.
Please go ahead. Let's hear it.
You guys are helping me kind of with defining this, but I really need somebody that's super organized, somebody that can handle the paperwork on the back end, that loves filing, because paperwork is a nightmare for me. My desk is just so cluttered. I want to be able to hand. You know, a lot of these producers, whether salesmen, they have somebody on the back end that helps them. They go out and make the sales, and then they hand everything over, and they have an assistant that helps them keep on track with what they're doing and make sure all the processes are getting fulfilled and helps with the marketing and all that. So that's what I'm looking for. And I need somebody to kind of whip me in shape because I have enough ADD to diagnose two people. So I need somebody to kind of get me back on track all the time. So if you know somebody like that that's looking for an opportunity.
And it's an amazing opportunity, too, because not only do you get to work with some of the most brilliant minds in real estate, and you will actually be able to learn how to do this, how to invest in real estate. So you get paid, you learn how to invest in real estate, and it becomes probably the greatest career move of anyone listening right now.
Yeah, you can send a resume to Phil. I think he can pre-screen them so that he Phil at addictedtorealestate.com. Phil at addicted2realestate.com.
Well, let me tell you what I think. That
put
position.
I'm crazy in the subject line.
I'm crazy.
I'll tell you what I think. I think we're looking for somebody who is very organized, somebody who is very computer savvy. Jeremy is a bit of a computer genius. He can do things with his phone that people can't figure out how to do with their computer right in front of them. And you're going to need to be able to be a high-tech kind of person. What you're also going to need to do is be a boss, because Jeremy calls the position Jeremy's assistant. But what you're really going to do is be Jeremy's boss. You're going to call me up. I'm going to tell you what Jeremy needs to do, and then you're going to make sure Jeremy does it. So you're going to be working with Jeremy, but you will actually be his boss. I will give you that authority in writing.
And when the two of them, when you can't stand the two of them, you'll come into my office and you'll complain about them both, and I'll just listen with nod my head.
That's right, a very negative thing to say, Larry.
Let's get on to the next pillar. I really do need the help. But,
you know,
if
you want to know what the other two pillars are, you should come out to the meeting tonight, because it's too important to just rush with the last minute that we have available to speak. We got 3 minutes left, and we want to just tell you guys, come out to the meeting tonight. It's at Maggie's Waterfront Cafe at 7 p.m. Costs $20 to attend. We got a huge, beautiful room up there overlooking the Delaware River. And we're going to share with you tonight about how do we make amazing real estate deals. And we make them with none of our own money. And when you learn how to buy houses with none of your own money, you will learn something that will stay with you the rest of your life. It is amazing talent to have. It's an amazing skill to possess. And it's really easier than you think. Come out to the meeting tonight. I promise you, we're going to share with you something that you will never, ever forget.
Not only private money, but seller financing and subject to taking over mortgages. Those are the two other pillars that we're going to discuss. And I think that when people find out that you can do deals with none of your own money, they will they'll find out that they're qualified.
Yeah, and you know, and I'll also share with you, if you guys want to pull me up privately, I'll tell you a little bit about the subject to deal that Jeremy taught me, the first one that cost me $1,724 out of my pocket, and it was an amazing deal, $40,000 equity, $400 a month positive cash flow. I'll also tell you how to become a real estate agent and how we will pay for your license to become a real estate agent, because it's, I tell you, once you become a real estate agent and once you start seeing the deals that you can get and the deals you can put together, you're going to be very, very happy that we paid for your real estate license. And, of course, you can call me anytime, 215-378-9190, and I will tell you how that works.
All right. And if you guys if you know anybody out there who is in the real estate-related business and are interested in being a sponsor and want to be a guest on this show, you can give me a call at 267-988-2000. Don't forget to come to our meeting tonight. I'm Phil Falcone from Addicted to Real Estate. You want to close it out, Jeremy?
I sure will. Listen to us this Thursday, every Thursday, next Thursday, the following Thursday. Thursday's at 3 on WWDB. That's 8:60 a.m., and you're listening to Addicted to Real Estate Radio. Take care, everyone.